to get this far. Let's move out. I'll take point. Stay close, everyone.
We're right behind you, boss.
Glad you decided to come with us. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
Yeah, I used to like living here. Before the war.
What do you mean? Before what war? Are you saying...
I lived here over 200 years ago. I was frozen or something. For most of it. Just woke up a little while ago.
Damn. Like one of those old pre-war ghouls. You say you were frozen. Anybody else make it out with you?
My son. Somebody took him while I was still trapped. Have you run across anybody with a baby boy?
Damn. I'm sorry. But no. I haven't run across any kidnapped babies. I'll definitely keep an eye out for him. Anyway, I am glad you're here. And I hope you don't mind, but I've got another favor to ask. I've had word from a settlement asking for help. There's still hope in there are Minutemen out there, somewhere. The only chance to start rebuilding the Minutemen is to show people that they can count on us when they need us. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you could go help out the settlement?
Oh, good. I was hoping for a chance to rescue some more helpless villagers.
It's not that people are helpless. They just need someone to give them a helping hand sometimes. That's what the Minutemen are supposed to be all about. By the way, if you want to help out around here at all, talk to Sturgis. I'm sure he'd be glad for all the help he can get.
Hey, do you have a moment? I wanted to thank you for helping us out in Concord. If only we'd run into you sooner.
What happened to you guys?
Long story short, we've been on the move since the attack on Quincy. There used to be more of us. My son, he's gone.
Your son? What was his name?
Kyle. My son's name was Kyle.
I understand how you feel. I lost someone too.
But you and I, we're still here, right? We have to go on. For them.
Sanctuary. I knew you'd join us here, kid. Your energy is tied to this place.
I hope the color of my energy is blue.
That's good. Humor is a good way to cope. Because this world ain't yours, is it? I saw you leave that icebox. The site can help you, kid. It always has answers. Just gotta bring me some jet so I can see what it wants to tell you.
Here. Already have some.
Like a little kick yourself, huh? This'll do. Now, let me ride the high to where the site wants to take me. Diamond City holds answers, but they're locked tight. You ask them what they know, but people's hearts are chained up with fear and suspicion. But you find it. You find that heart that's gonna lead you to your boy. Oh, it's bright. So bright against the dark alleys it walks. That's what you need to do, kid. Follow the signs to the bright heart. Phew. Wow. That took more out of me than usual. I'm gonna need to rest now, kid.
You willing to do some work?
I'd be glad to help. Just tell me what you need.
Well, for starters, we could use some real beds. We've been sleeping on the ground for too long. Just make sure we can sleep with a roof over our heads. Some of these old houses still look solid enough to do the trick. There's a workbench over there you can use. Give me a holler if you need anything.
Sturgis.
I like it. Having a place to sleep, what we need now is a reliable source of clean water.
I'm on it. Clean water coming up.
Great. Thanks again.
Take offense to Marcy. She's working through the loss in her own way.
Sturgis.
I feel better already, knowing we have a reliable supply of clean water. I hope you don't mind me asking for some more help, but our food supplies are running low. If we're gonna settle here, we'll need to get some crops established.
I'll start planting right away.
Good deal.
Seems to be growing well. growing well. Sturgis.
Well, this place is starting to feel like home. Now that we can grow our own food, I think we can really make a go of this. Trouble is, the more we establish ourselves here, the more of a target we become. What we need is to get some defenses set up. Then maybe Preston will be able to relax a little bit.
I'm on it.
Ah, thanks. It'll make everyone feel more secure here.
That'll help make everyone feel a little more secure. Thanks. It's been a long road. But yeah, I think this is it. Home. Feels good.
I was glad to help.
Well, I appreciate it. Of course, you know you're welcome anytime. My door's always open to you. Windows, too. Some of the walls, actually, come to think of it. I guess I better get back to it. Take care now.
don't need any more trouble around here.
Take it easy. I'm with the Minutemen. I'm here to help.
You're with the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing traitors, but honestly, I never expected anything to come of it. Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days after Quincy. Bad business, that.
We're rebuilding the Minutemen from the ground up. We're the good guys again.
Glad to hear it. No question that things have been worse since the Minutemen fell to pieces. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks, stealing food and supplies, threatening to kill us all if we don't pony up. We know where they're coming from, but we can't go up against a gang like that.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
Thanks, friend. If you folks are for real this time, it'll be a welcome change for the better.
He had everything he needed before he started his camping trip in that little shack up top. Double checked his list and everything. And that's why they call it Ian the Road.
Ah, and this guy invented
Transcendentalism, moron. You sound like...
Hi.
You find those raiders?
They're history. Now, what do you say about joining the Minutemen? Helping others when they need it.
You helped us, so it'd be pretty ungrateful of us to turn our backs on other folks. If we want things to get better, we've got to start helping each other. So, we're in. You can count on us if you need help down the line. Thanks again, friend.
Somewhere.
Hey! Who's there? Okay, nothing there now. What do you think?
Got it. Come on. No way I'm cracking this. Can't break the code. One more only. Nice.
Things are tough now, but they'll get better.
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the job. By the way, you should have one of these flare guns. You can use it to signal for help from any nearby Minutemen. Not much use yet, but once we have more allied settlements, you'll have help whenever you need it. I guess you know I'm one of the last of the Minutemen. But I never really told you what happened to us.
Are you really the last Minuteman?
Maybe not literally. There must be a lot of former Minutemen out there who gave it up in disgust after the Quincy massacre. But we were the last active group of Minutemen. And now, well, it's just me.
What was the Quincy massacre?
I thought everyone in the Commonwealth knew about that by now. I was with Colonel Hollis's group. A mercenary group called the Gunners was attacking Quincy. The people there called for the Minutemen to help. We were the only ones that came. The other groups, they just turned their backs on us and the folks in Quincy. Only a few of us got out alive. Colonel Hollis was dead, so I ended up in charge of the survivors. We never found a safe place to settle. One disaster after another. You saw how it ended and conquered.
As long as you don't give up, the Minutemen will survive.
I'm not about to give up, but I can't protect the Commonwealth all by myself. Hell, I could barely protect these people. That's why I'm talking to you. I can't rebuild the Minutemen, but I think you can.
I don't know what makes you think that.
You saved us and conquered. There wasn't anything in it for you. You had your own problems to deal with, but you did it anyway. That kind of selflessness has been in mighty short supply around here for quite a while. We need someone who can bring the whole Commonwealth together in a common cause. And I think you've got it in you to be that leader.
What makes you think I can do this?
You saved us and conquered. There wasn't anything in it for you. You had your own problems to deal with. That kind of selflessness has been in mighty...
No, I'm not your savior. I have my own problems to deal with.
I get it. You can't take care of other people's problems when you're still overwhelmed by your own. But one day, I hope you change your mind and accept my proposal. The Commonwealth needs you.